Well, we've had political appointments that people thought would never happen. You know, I cried when I saw a Black woman become the mayor of Ferguson. I cried when I saw Wesley Bell become the prosecutor. We've had the development of organizations like Forward Through Ferguson and Action St. Louis and the work of MCU and the work of Missouri Faith Voices and the work of Jobs for Justice be amplified. We've seen people who were ostracized be invited to tables to help make decisions. We've seen the rise of Deaconess Center as a major player, the work of the Urban League continuing to grow. It's amazing that they've given out over $1 million worth of food to people, and all of those people aren't of one color. And so there's amazing collaborative work that's happening in St. Louis. And I think I see it differently now because I don't get to be a part of that, right? Because I'm in and out all of the time. But I watch it and I'm extremely proud of the young people who have come up in this movement. I'm watching this movement have a different temperature and a different feel, a different tenor that you can even feel from live streams than movements of the past. More accountability. I think there's so many wonderful things happening. And I credit the consistent and persistent leadership of young people in this moment. It is amazing. It is amazing. And they are not just stopping in the street, they're running for office. There are comprehensive plans for us to move forward with. It's an exciting time. And I just want us to lean into the spiritual components of this time so that it does not require the sacrifice of Black life or anyone's life for us to live as we were intended. I have been racking my brain trying to figure out, what is it about this moment? I'm grateful about this moment, but it cannot be just that George Floyd was killed, because we have watched Black men and Black women be killed in ways that we can view over and over again. It can't just be that. I'm trying to pinpoint what that is that made compassion click on, that made turning a blind eye no longer acceptable, because it clearly is happening in this moment. I do think that we have a moral obligation as a human family to make sure everyone has what they need. And I think we start by paying a living wage. And I think we start by making sure everyone has some form of insurance that they can afford. And I think we start by recognizing the brilliance in every child that is born and doing all we can as a community to make sure that that child has the best opportunities to succeed. And I see some of that happening here. I see the work of WashU when they gave some scholarships to organizers who were clearly brilliant because they're finishing the work. They're graduating from WashU. Many of them have clearly capable of doing the work, right? But the doors of opportunity are not open to everyone, and they're not open to the same degree to everyone. So what can we do as a collective community? And all of the things, I can tell you all these technical things to do, but the main thing that has to happen in our region and across this nation is an awakening to the fact that these are not things I'm asking you to do for people who look like me or people who look like my Latinx companions or people who look like my First Peoples companions. These are not salvific natures, salvific motions for my community. These are salvific motions for us all. I'm not just trying to save Black people. I'm trying to save white people. Because we all have to recognize our humanity. And in this country, we have become a country that has diminished people down to the color of their skin. That doesn't benefit white people any more than it benefits me. What does it mean when a person is nothing more than white? What does it mean when a person is nothing more than black?